Trek Wrestling here inside Carver Hawkeye Arena, Iowa over Ohio State tonight. Of course, a lot of the talk coming in was the matchup with Nathan Tomasello, who joins us here against Corey Clark. How disappointed are you, Nathan, when you expect a big match and it just doesn't happen for whatever reason?
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, I wanted to wrestle him, and I'm sure he wanted to, But you just keep working, and whoever they have, just same game plan, go after it. So I'm sure I'll see him in the next couple weeks at the Big Tens or Nationals.
Is it fair to say that when you're expecting a matchup against a guy like Clark and it doesn't happen, just naturally you maybe let off the gas a little bit?
Yeah, the coaches talked to me a little bit as before we competed, and they're like, just same things, stressing, attacking, moving my feet, moving my hands, and it's tougher to get up for the match, but I mean, it's Carver Hawkeye, and you got a lot of people in the gym, and you got an opponent trying to rip your head off, so I still get up for the match.
One thing I appreciate with you, Nathan, is, you know, talking to you like this. We've done a bunch of interviews. You're, you know, pretty cool guy, laid back. But when it's go time, and I go back to last year, I remember going to Penn State. You and Megalutis are going at it. You're walking out that tunnel. I've never seen that kind of look before, maybe on anybody. Speak about where you go and how you get there when the light shines bright, when you know you got to have everything you got.
Yeah, it's like the eye of the tiger, you know. I just want to compete as hard as I can, and I get really focused before the match and just visualize a little bit of my attacking scheme and just going after it, getting kind of mean, you know, out there. That's what it requires, so, yeah.
How was the move up to 133, Ben?
It's nice. It's good to focus more on my technique and to keep my strength up and maintaining my mass and stuff like that. So it's been a great year so far. I want to keep building on my wins and keep building on learning's key and improving, so I can put the best out there when it matters the most.
I know reading stuff on you with social media articles, stuff like that. I was talking to Luke Pletcher about this before. I love the letter P when it comes to wrestling. Physicality, pace, pressure, passion. In Pletcher's case, I like his poise. When I think about you, Nathan, you got pretty good perspective. I know you're a man of faith, and that kind of navigates, you know, your journey and keeps everything to perspective. Talk to me about that a little bit.
Yeah, Christ is first. Jesus Christ is first, and it allows me to relax and know that it's his will that when I wrestle out there, I know that he's there. He's always there, and he's someone to fall back on. And just having a deep faith in the Lord is important. It's the most important thing in my life, and I try to spread that to everyone I can.
Want to go back to last year, of course, in wrestling. You got to have a short memory. You know, things happen. You've been phenomenal. Won the national title as a freshman last year. You lose to Gilman in the semis. You're not a guy that's used to losing. What do you remember about that night? What was the value that you'll take moving forward from that night, that tough loss?
Yeah, it was very disappointing. It really hit me hard that night. And your dreams are shattered. You know, I expected to win that tournament, and I lost. I lost in the semis. I needed to come back, and it was crushing. I mean, it took a lot out of me, but having people surround me, great people surrounding me, and having, like I said, a deep faith in the Lord and knowing and trusting his plan and his will has helped me come back even stronger and have even more persistence to win it this year. And it was tough, but I'm excited to get back in that stage again.
Was there any conversation in particular, any words of wisdom, advice that was given you that you'll remember for a real long time, maybe not only in wrestling, but the rest of your life?
Not that I can think of right now offhand, but Coach Travell Dolognov and Coach Ryan and Jay, they just love, you know. They love you no matter what, and that meant a lot, you know. And I'm sure they were devastated, and I could see it in their faces. And just having their love was important at that moment.
Really appreciate catching up, and I will talk to you soon. Thanks, Nathan.
No problem.